Hey guys, what's going on and welcome to my YouTube channel, The Accumulation Zone, the YouTube channel where you are going to learn everything about day trading. In today's video, we are going to be testing a new type of RSI. It's called the Laguerre RSI. So we are going to add this Laguerre RSI, the one with the most likes here, onto our chart. And we are going to adjust the settings down to alpha 0.1. We can also change the style to make the colors more bright. I changed the color of the LA RSI to yellow, made it a little bit thicker here. And I changed the color of those two lines, the 80 and the 20 line, to white. Alright, we also are going to need a EMA with the length of 180. And we also changed the style here in the style section to yellow and make it a little bit thicker. Alright guys, so now that we know which indicators we are going to be using in this video, I am going through with you guys for a few entry signals. Alright, so we would enter a long position if the Laguerre RSI is crossing the 20 line here, the white line at the bottom, from the bottom to the top, so a crossover. That would be our entry condition. Let me make it extra clear. We are using a vertical line here on this candle. On this candle here, we cross the Laguerre RSI from the bottom through to the top, and we are also above the 180 EMA. So we are going to enter a long position. We are placing our stop loss a little bit below the last swing low to give it a little bit of breathing room, and we are going to be targeting a 2-to-1 risk reward. Let me actually make it better. Yeah, 2-to-1 risk reward, and we see that's a winning trade. I'm going to show you another example. Here, right here, we cross the Laguerre RSI from the bottom to the top. It's a valid crossover. I mark it up for you. And we are going to place our stop loss again at the most recent swing low, give it a little bit of breathing room, and we see we are going to target a 2-to-1 risk reward, which worked out perfectly. Now here we have a little short example. We see this time we're crossing the Laguerre RSI from the top through to the bottom, so a cross under. And if we see that happening, we enter a short position. We place our stop loss at the most recent swing high, which would be this one. Give it a little of breathing room. You never know. With spreads and commissions, you might end up getting stopped out. And we see again, a 2-to-1 risk reward ratio is no problem at all. So you make, if you, for example, risk 1% with every trade here, you would make 2% profit if it's hitting your take profit. Alright, let's have a look at another entry signal. That's a losing signal. They are going to happen, but remember we have a 2-to-1 risk reward ratio. That means with every winning trade, you are going to make twice as much as you're risking. It's all about risk management when trading. Alright, here we would have entered a short position because we the LA RSI crossed the 80 line from top to bottom, so a cross under. And we would have entered the trade right here on close of this candle below the 180 EMA. We would have placed our stop loss at the most recent swing high right here, maybe give it a little bit of breathing room, and risk 1% of our account size. And try to target a 2-to-1, we obviously see that's not going to happen. You could, for example, exit the trade earlier with a 180 EMA cross. So that's completely up to you. And because we were still in this trade, we didn't enter a new long position. If you would have left the trade earlier, because we would have seen a LRSI cross into the oversold area, you could have left that trade earlier, right here, and wait for the next setup, which happened right here on this candle. We had the LA RSI cross, and we are above the 180 EMA. So we would be all good to enter into a long position and target a 2-2-1 and see how that works out. And it's a winning trade. So you would have already made back twice as much as you lost with this little losing trade. Even more because you exited a little bit earlier. So you see, it's a very profitable strategy in my opinion. Here we stayed in the oversold area of the LA RSI for quite a long time. So you could have trailed that trade and just keep holding it until it's crossing the 180 EMA to exit a trade. Alright, here's another example where we dipped down during that massive uptrend here on the 30 minute chart on pound yen. We had another pullback and another cross. We entered, we're above the 180 EMA, 2-to-1 risk reward ratio, and we have another winner. I'm gonna show you guys one more short example. Let's have a look. Your long example, actually. This one here, we had a cross of the Lagwear RSI exactly on this candle, and we're also above the 180 EMA right when this candle's closing. Gonna zoom in here a little bit. Right, we place our stop loss at the most recent swing low and target a 2-to-1 risk reward ratio. Alright, perfect. We see that's another winner. And remember, we want to see crosses right here and we want to be above the 200 and 180 EMA. Alright guys, I'd say I'm getting down to code the strategy into code and make it available for you and see how profitable it is over the long term. Alright guys, I see you soon. Alright guys, I finished coding the strategy in PineScript and I just want to let you know I am going to be sharing the whole source code of everything in my for all my Patreon subscribers. So if you're interested in using this strategy, feel free, just support me on Patreon and you get access to all my source codes of all the strategies I've coded so far on YouTube. Alright, but now let's actually see how profitable that strategy turns out to be. Let's turn it on. And we can already, let's adjust the properties. Let's say we have a $1,000 account. And we risk one contract. Let's actually make it 10 contracts. That load. And we see it's a super profitable strategy with a net profit of 42% and a max drawdown of 3.06%. It is 49.38% profitable and has a profit factor of 2.353. We closed 81 trades over the period of 2 years. Now, from the beginning of 2020 till now, so almost 2.5 years on a 30-minute chart. But you can use this script and adjust all the settings down to a 5-minute or even 1-minute time frame and connect it to FreeCommerce, AutoView or Pine Connector. And yeah, just let it run automatically or trade it manually. That's what I usually do. I set alerts for the strategy and then I qualify or manually select certain trades I'm getting alerted from and I'm only trading them manually. Yes, and I modified the take profit and stop loss settings of that script. So here you can also set your commission and your slippage and your margin, whatever you need. And here in the input section, you are able to change the risk to reward. And I'm using the stop loss method with the ATR, the average true range, which is incorporating the volatility at the point of the entry. So I'm using here for those results an ATR multiplier of 2 and an EMA fit of 1A. But you can adjust those settings however you like on whatever currency you want, on stocks, crypto and forex, and adjust the settings and see if it's profitable, and afterwards set alerts and you're good to go and trade with the alerts. All right. Let's go over those trades. Here you see, instead of this small trade, it placed the stop loss a little bit lower to give the trade more breathing room. So that's the actual trade, and we see it is still a winner. It just took a little bit longer. So that's the difference of trading manually and placing the stop loss with your intuition and with your knowledge. And that's how Colt would place it. Let's go back and see here. Here it worked out fine. The ATR gave us a little bit more breathing room to the downside, and we hit take profit up here. Same with this trade, it took us short here and we exited the trade here. So if you would have traded it manually, you could have already left your position here, took this long trade, take profit right here, or you would have, you maybe could have held the trade until it's crossing the 180 EMA again up till here and make some insane profits. That would be a, let me actually see that, that would be roughly a 11 risk to reward ratio. So it is definitely possible to make good profits with the strategy. Here again, the ATR gave us a little bit more breathing room, maybe too much. You wouldn't set it at this level if you traded manually. You would maybe set it here and take profit here and then maybe re-enter again and make more trades instead of just one single big one. But that's the thing with Colt. You backtest all the settings with certain values on over those 81 trades we took in that period of time. We made more profit having the ATR multiplier of 2. And sometimes that means we have a very, very, very big stop loss. But in general, therefore, we lose less trades because we have a bigger stop loss. Alright, if I, for example, change it to 1 to have a tighter stop loss, we see we're gonna lose more trades because of that tighter stop loss. It's just the occasion. That's why I highly recommend using the alerts of the strategy and trading them manually instead of automating it. It's on a half an hour chart. Everyone is able to take trades on a half an hour chart whenever you get an alert to manually filter it. Alright, so I'm pretty happy with those results, and like I said, if you want to use this strategy and see the code, you can support me on Patreon, and I am going to upload it very soon, and I'm going to change the whole system around. I'm not going to have invite-only scripts anymore. I am going to upload them to a Google Drive so you can copy the source code and put them here into Pynet editor, save them, and then they appear here under the My Script sections. And yeah, you're good to go. And if you're interested in me coding your personal strategy you maybe don't want to share on YouTube, feel free to contact me on Fiverr. The links are below in the description. And we are going to be doing a live FTMO challenge with all of you in our Telegram group. So if you're interested, feel free to join us there. We are going to share daily setups of from the stock market, the forex market, and the crypto market to pass an FTMO challenge. Alright guys, that's it for me. Feel free to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and don't forget to smash the like button if this video was helpful in any kind of way. And yeah, I see you guys in the next YouTube video. Cheers!